हेलो फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस डिफरेंट फेजेस ऑफ ए कंपाइलर इन डिटेल, स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ए कंपाइलर इन डिटेल. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस फेजेस ऑफ ए कंपाइलर, बट हियर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस हाउ द पर्टिकुलर इंस्ट्रक्शन विच इज़ टू बी कन्वर्टेड इन अ मशीन अंडरस्टैंडेबल कोड और मशीन कोड. सो देर आर डिफरेंट स्टेजेस और डिफरेंट स्टेप्स और डिफरेंट व्हाट वी कैन से दैट different stages are available for conversion process. Lexical analysis, syntax analysis, semantic analysis, intermediate code generation, code optimization, target code generation, symbol table and error handler. let's discuss these things in detail one by one. First one is lexical analysis. Lexical analysis is also called as scanner. It takes high level language or high level instruction as a input and produces token for the given input string. So role of lex is here to take the instruction and produces stream of tokens. Second one is keep the track line of numbers. Third one is the prepare the symbol table, and fourth one is generate the error if available. Okay, these are the few things or role which is to be generated by the lexical analysis scanner or lex. In market, lex tool is available on Linux, which is used to generate to convert a particular instruction in a token format. What it performs? Convert the stream of characters representing input program into sequence of tokens. Token are the words of the programming language lexem, the character comprising a token, or what we can say that the lexem is nothing but meaningful sequence of a character. For instance, the sequence of character static int is recognized as the two tokens representing the two words, that is static and int. The sequence of characters are x plus plus is recognized as three tokens, that is representing star is there, x is there, and plus plus. Remove the word spaces and remove the comment. Yes, also this is the another responsibility or role of a lexical analysis. It will remove the word spaces, blank spaces, or remove the blank remove the comment from the given string, given instruction. So this is the example, that is input result is equal to a plus b into 10. So the token for the given input string is result is equal to a plus b into symbol and 10. So identifier in here, the instruction is result a b and 10. Okay, and operators are is equal to, that is assignment operator, plus and multiplication. So there are 7 token which is to be generated for the given input string. So what is token? Token is nothing but the category or class of a input for the given instruction. So for this, the tokens are 7 tokens are here, identifiers and operators. So 4 identifiers are available and 3 operators are available. Next, syntax analysis or parsing. Syntax analysis and parsing is also called as parser. The responsibility of parser is to take the stream of token from the lexical analysis and produces the derivation tree or parse tree according to the grammar available. And if the whole input string is to be scanned, then parse tree is to be generated, otherwise error is to be generated. It uncovers the structure of sentence in the program from a stream of tokens. For instance, the phrase x is equal to plus y, which is recognized as 4 tokens representing x is equal to and x, sorry, plus and y, has the structure is equal to in bracket x plus in bracket y. That is the assignment expression that operates on x and the expression plus y. Build a tree called a parse tree that replaces the structure of a input string. That we already discussed, that the syntax analysis, it takes the stream of token and generate the parse tree for the given input string. Now expression grammar. Expression is equal to expression plus expression. So this is the grammar for the given input string. So expression produces expression plus expression also or expression into expression id or number. This is the syntax analysis or parsing grammar for the given input string. Yes, see here, result is equal to a plus b into 10. So this is the parse tree or derivation tree for the given input string. Semantic analysis, it concerns the semantic, or what we can say that it generates the meaningful sequence of the character for the given input string. It performs the type checking, operand compatibilities to be checked over here. Intermediate code generation, yes, it will generate the three address code for the given input string, which is to be generated from intermediate, semantic analysis. It translates each hierarchical structure decorated as tree into intermediate code. A program translated for an abstract machine. Properties of intermediate code should be easy to generate, should be easy to translate, and intermediate code hides many machine level details but has the instruction level mapping to many assembly language. It is used for three address code generation. Code optimization, which is used to reduce the size of a code. It applies a series of transformation to improve the time and space efficiency of the generated code. Pfold optimization generates a new instruction by the combining expanding on small number of consecutive instruction. Optimization, so the main thing of code optimization is to generate or to optimize the code or to reduce the size of code. Code generation, it maps the instruction in the intermediate code to specific machine instruction, memory management, register allocation, instruction selection, and instruction scheduling, which is to be done with the help of code generation. Symbol table and error handler. So symbol table and error handler, we already discussed that thing. Symbol table, it is the which is used to generate the symbol, new symbol, which is to store the new symbol which is to be generated during the compilation process. And error handler, which is used to generate the handle the error which is to be generated during the lexical, syntax and semantic phase. Okay. Translation of a statement over here. Result is equal to a plus b into 10 is given to the lexical analysis. So lexical analysis generated id1 is equal to id2 plus id3 into 10. So here four identifiers and three operators are available. Syntax analyzer generate the parse tree or derivation tree for the given input string. This string is given to the semantic analysis. Semantic analysis generate it will generate to what we can say that typecasting is to be generated over here, or semantical verification is to be done over here. Now next, this is given to the intermediate code generation. Intermediate code generation perform the three address code for the given input string. So what is three address code? Three address code, it is the code which is to be only three addresses or three variables is to be available in the particular instruction. Code optimizer perform optimization of the given input string, and code generation perform the or create the assembly code output for the given input string. So this is for compilation process. Okay, thank you so much.